Familiar rustle of capitalism at work.
We got everything. Operation Alley Goes to College is completo.
Except, you know, the going to college.
Oh, 2 days. I can't believe it. And I can't believe that I'm not going to be able to take you, Alley.
It's okay. I think they'd miss the Secretary of State at the United Nations General Assembly. Dad and I will be fine.
Oh, no.
And that is Mom. Catherine Herzer alongside Taya Leone in the hit CBS series Madam Secretary. It's returning next month for its fourth season. And Catherine is with us here. Good morning. Thank you so much for being here.
Of course. Thank you for having me. That's actually the first time I've seen a clip from season four.
Oh.
Yeah.
How did you feel seeing it?
It's so cute. I mean, it's so nice to be back. And I don't know, the family's better than ever, so it's sweet to finally see it.
Okay, most people have seen this show, but for folks who haven't, tell us a little bit about the show.
Well, it's about the Secretary of State and how she balances her family life and her career, which, I mean, for anyone is really hard, and especially for someone that high up in the government.
So. And you're the daughter, right?
I am the daughter.
Okay.
I'm the middle daughter, which we had a fun little stint talking about back a few seasons ago, so that was like an important element to the story, which was funny.
And how is it working with such a great cast, especially someone like Taya Leone?
It's amazing. Yeah. I mean, Taya is such an incredible person, and she's such a hard worker, and being able to learn from her has just been such a gift.
How do you think the show balances work and family life?
I think it does a really great job of showing how they conflict and how they interact, because, I mean, they're not separate entities. They have to sort of, like, we have scenes where we work with her staff, or we get in trouble and they have to sort of take care of us, and or, like, with my sister on the show going and working in the White House. It's a very fluid movement back and forth, so I love that we do so much with the family and so much with their exchange.
Now, being an actress on such a politically charged show, has it kind of piqued your interest in politics a little bit more?
Well, I think the timing was sort of perfect. It's like, how could I not get engaged with everything that's going on in the world? And I mean, I'm around people that are constantly talking about politics and I don't know how we can do better things with the government. Mm-hmm. Our show is really aspirational in that way. We want to know how we can make the world a little better, like how we can have a secretary that is really doing the best she can to better people's individual lives.
And tell us a little bit about your work with the Creative Coalition.
Yeah, Tim is actually who got me involved with that. He is just such a rock star. He's such a great person, and he's been so kind to me and so generous with bringing me in on that. And it's about getting creative people that have had success and making sure that they work to get funding for the arts. So our big mission is to make sure that the NEA stays alive and healthy, because there's constantly fear of it getting cut, and it does so much to help people that, I mean, it does, the arts does so many things for so many people. And Tim always says this, that people don't have a problem calling themselves a golfer, but everyone's afraid to call themselves an artist. But we're all artists. We all sing in the shower. We all, you know, tell jokes and a million other, we all sometimes doodle. So it's important to make sure that people are exposed to it at a young age, and that it helps with any sort of trouble that you go through in your life. I think that it's one of the best therapies that you can have. So with this crazy time in the world, you have to find ways to sort of release those things, and the arts is one of them. We need to make sure everyone has access.
It's a great project. And you were telling me you're in the middle of filming the fourth season now. You're just in LA for some personal business and family business.
Yes.
But you actually don't shoot in DC.
No, we don't shoot in DC. I mean, actually the first time we did anything in DC was like our last two episodes of season three.
Okay.
I actually didn't go even. But
you're in New York, Brooklyn.
Yeah, we're in Greenpoint, in a nice, cute little Polish neighborhood, and and we love it. Yeah, I mean, it's crazy to see how much it's changed, because now it's so trendy and it's all of these things that it wasn't before. Well, it was starting to be, but yeah, we have our cute little spot in New York, and we film so many things as other things.
Yeah,
you would be so surprised. I mean, one time we filmed India at a sewage plantation in Greenpoint, and they make it look so beautiful, and it's just so cool.
New York has a very talented cast and crew.
Yes, yeah. Our crew is insane.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Well, good luck with the fourth season.
Thank
we can't
you.
Wait to see it.
Thank you so much for having me.
And you can see Catherine on Madam Secretary. Again, the fourth season premieres Sunday, October 8th on our sister station, CBS2. And we'll be right back.